Okay, the next thing we're going to learn about is how do we parse XML. Now, I'm not going to make you write an actual parser. I think there's actually probably a whole class on Udacity learning to how to do almost exactly that. What I'm going to show you how to do is use the built-in parser in Python. Python has a library called minidom, and you can get it by saying something like this. Now, one thing I would like to point out real quick here is when you're working with XML, you'll often see this word DOM up here. And what this stands for is Document Object Model. And this basically refers to the the internal representation of an XML document. So this would be, you know, in Python, you would have an object that has, a list of children, and each, child may, each of these children is some sort of tag object, and a tag object may have, a name and an attribute and contents and that sort of thing. You'll see this in any time you're dealing with XML programmatically, you'll see references to a DOM. Or if you're editing, if you're working in your browser, you'll see references to the DOM, which kind of refers to the document, the HTML that you're manipulating programmatically. And in this particular case, we're going to use minidom. Why is it called minidom and not something else? Well, the mini kind of implies that this is a smaller, lightweight version of this DOM parser. And actually, parsing XML is actually a really complicated thing, because you can get XML that is, many, many gigabytes large sometimes. And parsing all of that text is non-trivial. But when you're only parsing a little bit of text, you can use this library, minidom, which is basically simple and fast and will break if you throw lots and lots of gigabytes of text at it. But for our purposes, will work just great. I'm not going to quiz you on this sort of stuff. Just kind of carry this with you. DOM refers to the computer representation of the XML, and minidom is a handy library for manipulating this stuff in Python. And now I will show you how to use it. Here we are in Python. I'm going to give you a little demo of minidom before you start using it on your own. From xml.dom, import minidom. Okay, so now we have our minidom thing. Minidom has a function on it called parse string, which is a function for just parsing a string of XML. So let's go ahead and give that a whirl. Okay, so I've typed up some example HTML. Here we have an opening my tag, some text, an opening children tag. Now remember, these tag names I'm just making up. HTML has specific tags that you need to use. XML, you can have whatever arbitrary tags you want. It's up to the people reading and writing the XML to agree on the tag names. I created some items, item one, item two. I closed my children tag, and I closed my tag. Now, when I was typing this, I had a little typo here, and I'm kind of curious to see what happens. So let's go ahead and run this with the typo and see. Oh, boy. So I ran this with the typo to see what would happen, and yeah, we get an error, a mismatched tag. That kind of makes sense. So, we have an opening children, and a closing children. So let's just make this proper. Okay, we're gonna run this without the typo, and I'm gonna store it in a variable, so I have access to it. I'll call it x. All right, this time no exception. And if we were to take a peek at x, we can see we have this minidom document instance. Let's take a peek at what we have on x. Holy smokes, look at all this stuff. There's a lot of interesting things here on x. Looks like append child, functions for manipulating the document, all this creating nodes and sort of stuff like that. Some lookup functions, these are what we're going to be using later. Get element by ID, get element by tag name. NS refers to a namespace. All sorts of stuff. Parent node, some output functions. Two pretty XML. This is actually an interesting one. Let's play with this one. This is one I use all the time. So if we were to take our document object and call two pretty XML on it, okay, two pretty XML. this actually doesn't look very pretty, does it at all? Let's print that, because it's printing it with, this is the Python string with the new lines in it. And if we were to actually print it, it would look a lot prettier. Here's the XML that I entered, and you can see the structure of the document, and it indents it nicely for us. So that's a handy little function. When you download XML from somewhere, you can see the structure of it a little bit more clearly with pretty XML. Okay, there's a function I'd like to show you here. Get elements by tag name. Now, if I were to run this function on our X object and give it my tag, it returns one DOM element. If I were to run it on item, we actually get two DOM elements. Looking at the first tag called item, we can see that we have an item. And if we were to look at its children, we can call child nodes to see a list of children. We can see that we have one text node. If we were to look at the first one of those, we can access the node value attribute and see that it's one. Now remember, our pretty printed version of our XML, what we just did here is we said, get me all of the elements that are called item, So here's one, and here's two. And on this first one, which is this guy here, get me its first child, which is basically this node here, which isn't strictly a node, but in mini DOM it's represented as a text node, which is basically just this text contents. Different libraries may handle contents differently, but in mini DOM this is how we get it. And then we can actually say get the value of that text node. And that's how we got the number one right there. And this U basically means that's a Unicode string. Mini DOM assumed that we were entering a Unicode string, which is fine.